Pounded yam with egusi soup is a classic Nigerian favorite. But what happens to your blood sugar when you eat it? I tested it using a glucose monitor called Dexcom, and the results might change how you think about our traditional foods. My name is Chris. I'm a registered pharmacist and a certified diabetes educator. Welcome to Glucose Vegan. Here's something that might shock you. In 2022, about 54 million adults in Africa were living with diabetes, and more than half didn't even know. That's millions of people walking around not knowing they have a condition that's silently damaging their health. Now you might be thinking, I don't have diabetes, so this doesn't affect me. But here's why you should pay attention. Being of African descent increases our chances of getting diabetes. In fact, Africa is expected to have the biggest increase in diabetes cases worldwide. And even if you don't have diabetes today, your blood sugar still matters. Every time we eat foods that make our blood sugar jump up quickly, we're stressing our blood vessels and organs. When this happens again and again, over time, it raises our risk of getting diabetes and heart disease. So what I'm going to show you in this video matters to every Nigerian, whether you live in Lagos, London, or Toronto. Please note that this video is for educational purposes only and not medical advice. For personalized nutritional health guidance, please consult with a healthcare professional or registered dietitian. Now, let's talk about what we've planned for today's video. I will be eating pounded yam with egusi soup, and I will track my blood sugar to see what effect this favorite meal of ours has on my body. To track my blood sugar, I will be using this device called Dexcom G7. It's a small sensor that goes under my skin and keeps checking my blood sugar levels all day long. That's why it's called a continuous glucose monitor. Let me break this down in simple terms. You know that finger prick test that checks your blood sugar? Well, Dexcom works differently. The finger prick test checks the sugar directly in your blood, but Dexcom checks the sugar in the water that surrounds all the cells in your body. We call this the interstitial fluid. Here's what makes Dexcom so useful. While a finger prick test only tells you your sugar level at that exact moment, Dexcom keeps watching and sends updates to my phone every 5 minutes, so I can see how my sugar goes up and down throughout the day. If I wanted to do this with a finger prick test, my poor fingers would probably fall off by noon. Now, because Dexcom checks sugar in a different place than the finger prick test, the numbers might not exactly be the same. But what matters is that it shows the same pattern. When sugar goes up, when it comes down, and by how much. Keep in mind that everybody's different. For myself, I have found that my blood sugar levels tend to be lower than for most people. Yours might be higher than mine, especially if you have diabetes or pre-diabetes. Also, I want to clearly state that this is not a sponsored video. I've been using Dexcom for several months now to manage my health. That being said, let's talk about the science behind the test. Research has shown that pounded yam has a high glycemic index of 82 to 85. What does glycemic index mean? Think of it like a speed meter from 0 to 100. The higher the number, the faster a food makes your blood sugar go up. So with a score of around 85, pounded yam is pretty far up on the scale, which means it can make your blood sugar rise very fast. Why is pounded yam so high on this speed meter? Yam by itself already has a medium to high score, depending on how you prepare it. But when we pound it, we break it down into tiny pieces that are much easier for our body to digest and turn into sugar quickly. But here's the thing, nobody eats pounded yam alone. We usually eat it with a egusi soup that has meat, fish, vegetables, and palm oil. These ingredients add protein, fat, and fiber. Research shows that when you eat this together with starchy foods like yam, it should slow down how fast your blood sugar rises. So the big question is, does eating pounded yam the way we Nigerians traditionally eat it actually help? Let's find out. Welcome to my kitchen. Let's set up the actual test. I want this to be as accurate as possible, so I'm going to measure everything. But I'll also try to make it as close to what I would normally eat, because in real life, we don't always measure our food. Here's what I'll be eating. This is 290 grams of pounded yam, and that's about the size of my palm. And for the egusi soup, this weighs 343 grams, and it contains beef, fish, and plenty of vegetables. I believe this is the typical portion that we would eat at home. Before I eat the food, I need to see what my current blood sugar level is. So let's do a finger prick test and compare it with Dexcom. All right, now my blood sugar is at 4.7 and Dexcom says it's at 4.4. So the readings are not exactly the same, but they're close. So we can trust Dexcom to show us what happens to my blood sugar. All right, with that out of the way, let's eat. Finally. Pounded yam with egusi soup is truly delicious, and I can see why it's one of our favorites. Now, all we have to do is wait while Dexcom tracks my blood sugar. We'll check what's happening at 30 minutes, 1 hour, 2 hours, and 3 hours. It's been 30 minutes since I finished eating. Let's check what Dexcom says. 6.3. As you can see, my blood sugar level is already going up, just as you would expect. Now let's keep going and we'll be back in another 30 minutes. It's been 1 hour since I ate the pounded yam. My blood sugar has gone up to 8.3. This is a bit of a jump from where we started, but we're not done yet. We'll be back in an hour. Stay tuned. So it's been 2 hours since I ate the pounded yam and egusi soup. And to be honest, I feel a little bit of a headache right now, so I'm actually curious to see what my Dexcom is. (laughs) 10.3. I'm gonna be honest with you, every part of me is telling me to go out and run. Like, do anything to bring your blood sugar down, but this is an experiment. I'm committed to it, and I'll see you in another hour. It's been 3 hours, and my blood sugar is sitting at 7.7. which is still higher than where we started. I'll actually let this play out for a little longer and we'll see how long it takes for my blood sugar to return to the starting point. Hello again, it's day two. I ended up tracking my blood sugar for a total of 5 hours last night. Let's take a closer look at the results now. Right now on the screen, you can see the blood sugar values that my Dexcom tracked during the experiment. This arrow shows the start of the experiment, which is when I finished eating, and these are the four measurements that I showed you on camera. As you can see, my blood sugar went from about 4.4 before the test all the way up to 10.3. That's a high number. The amount of pounded yam that I ate might not seem like a lot. After all, it fit into my palm. But pounded yam does actually contain a lot of sugar. And since it is fairly high on that speed mirror, your blood sugar can jump up quite a bit. Now, I want to clearly state that it is normal for your blood sugar to go up after a meal. And the more the sugar and the starch in the food, the higher it will go. But it's not just about how high your blood sugar goes. It's also important how quickly this happens and how long it stays high. For someone who doesn't have diabetes, we like to see a blood sugar stay under 7.8 2 hours after eating. But that's not what happened here. Again, my own reading after 2 hours was 10.3. This is higher than ideal, and there's a reason for that. There are two things going on here. First, my blood sugar went very high because pounded yam is so high in sugar. And second, this goes on for a long time because all the fat and protein in the egusi soup delay the digestion. For people without diabetes like myself, eating like this once a while, even though it's stressful for our body, is not dangerous. Our body can handle this. It has many ways of regulating our blood sugar. However, if you eat high starch foods like pounded yam regularly, maybe several times a week for many, many years, your body might start to get tired. It has to work harder and harder to bring your blood sugar down. And over time, this can lead to diabetes, which can damage your heart, kidneys, eyes, and nerves. And even without diabetes, high blood sugar can damage your blood vessels and cause many other problems. And that's why it's important to think about how often we eat foods like this, how much we eat, and what we do after. Now, if you have pre-diabetes or diabetes, your blood sugar might shoot up even higher than mine did and stay high for much longer. If that's your situation, I would strongly recommend not eating pounded yam and egusi the way I did. But here's the good news. We may not have to give up foods like pounded yam completely. We just need to be smarter about it. That's it for today. Now, I know I've talked about a lot of things in this video, and some of them might need a little more explanation, but I'll save that for future videos. In my next video, I'll test the same meal using a method recommended by nutrition experts called the plate method, and we'll see if this makes a difference to my blood sugar. The goal isn't to stop eating our favorite foods completely, but to find ways to enjoy them that keep us healthy in the long run. If you enjoyed this video, please like and share it with your family and friends, especially those who might be at risk of diabetes. Drop a comment below with other Nigerian foods you'd like me to test, and please make it jollof rice. Don't forget to follow Glucose Beacon for more reward tests and educational content about the foods we eat and other ways to prevent diabetes. Until next time, thank you for watching and stay healthy.